This video is transformative in nature. Any gameplay and commentary displayed in this video should be considered covered under fair use law. This game is rated M for mature. Viewer discretion is advised.
Whew, well, we've had a long day, so I guess we should probably get to bed. Yeah, it was an eyeball icon, that's correct. Yeah. That's actually really creepy. So there's probably some sort of mystical force behind it, and Igor did say it was him who was downloading it. I mean, it seems like we can. Alright, no Disney school tomorrow, got it. Let's go to bed. Back here again, huh? Welcome to prison.
Welcome to the Velvet Room.
Hey, Igor, how you been?
I thought about resuming our previous conversation tonight. That is why I have summoned you. What are your thoughts? Are you becoming accustomed to this place?
Yeah, oddly enough, I am in fact being accustomed to prison.
Ah, glad to hear it. It seems you have nerves of steel. Your rehabilitation determines if ruin can be stopped. Yet, such a feat cannot be done by you alone.
I figure I'm gonna need a couple friends along the way.
But today, you entered a partnership with someone who awoke to the same power, haven't you?
Yeah, how'd you guess? I'm assuming you mean Ryuji, so...
Involving yourself with others is an important foundation for your recovery. You've done well. That said, I am not advising the formation of superficial relationships.
So no simple social links, I need full-on confidants.
It must not be a frivolity, but a ring of those who would, by morals or faith, lend you their strength. In other words, they are bonds with those who have been robbed of their places to belong.
Huh.
The expansion of said ring will, in return, help you mature as well.
Personas are the strength of heart. The stronger the bonds that surround you, the more power your personas will gain.
Good to know.
There are countless people in the city who have talents that a weakling like you doesn't. You better rack that noggin of yours and get them on your side. We'll change that into power.
Alright, makes sense to me. Yep. Yes.
Indeed. You should be prepared to use even myself, or your ambitions will not come to fruition. We have a deal then.
Sounds good to me. Whatever the hell you are, Igor. I'm happy to be a confidant of some kind.
Thou hast acquired a new vow. It shall become the
wings of
rebellion that breaketh thy chains of captivity. With the birth of the fool persona, I have obtained the winds of blessing that shall lead to freedom and new power.
Sweet, we got Wild Talk. We can finally negotiate with Shadows. That's pretty good. And we got Arcana Burst. Using personas based on their Arcana's Confidant rank.
All right.
Sounds good to me. Both of these abilities seem really useful. Alright, each Confidant has their own abilities. Okay, makes sense.
Well, you will understand it all in due time. Continue devoting yourself to your rehabilitation.
Okay, I understand.
Now this conversation's over. Get lost, inmate.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that was eventful.
I can't do this.
Oh shit, today's the Riley. I forgot about that. I guess we can go around talking to all the volleyball players. How does nobody in this school know about the physical abuse? I just don't believe that that's true.
Okay, quiet down.
Yep. Volleyball rallies today. So what are we gonna do? Nice spike. You gotta give him that, at least. But Haikyuu, this is not.
Damn it.
Yeah, it does kind of seem like it's just nothing more than an ego stroke on his part. Let's get some evidence. Alright. Alright, dude, where are you gonna be searching? My class is class D, so that works out well. Yeah, dude, clearly I'm in the same boat. I'm probably in a worse boat than you. They think I'm an actual criminal. You might be a thug, but I'm an actual criminal at this point. Whatever. Oh wait, I could have just gone directly to the classroom. Why didn't I do that? Yeah, it doesn't matter. It's 2C, 2D over here. 2D, best member of the gorillas, fight me? Actually, no, that's not true. Noodle's probably the best. I want to ask you a question. How in the world did you get injured like that? I don't believe it's just from practice, man. You're a coward, is what you're telling me. Yeah, we don't have any of that. Because we gotta find somebody else. Maybe we should have actually had some physical evidence. Alright, let's split up. Alright. 3C, huh? I'll have to look that up. It's probably above us, right? So... floor. Got it. You got it, Ryuji. Let's go to the third floor. No real need to fast travel right now, at least. Let's see. For somebody who's injured, huh? Oh wait, he said first floor, didn't he? Maybe there is a reason. I forgot that the higher in the building you are, the younger you are. So that must mean... Oh, hey, look, it's Anne. Or on.
Yeah?
Yeah, they have been getting a little more complicated as time goes on.
Yeah.
Hey, look, I found a volleyball player. Dude, you look beaten up as hell. Dude, how in the world did you get this hurt? I don't believe that for a second. Somebody dedicated to training would make sure that his... would make sure that his team is actually in top condition and not destroyed like this. Dude, this is literally corporal punishment. Well, I mean, I do carry a knife around. They're not wrong on that one. But I'm usually only using it in the other world, I guess? He pretty much refused. One B. So, up on the third floor. Got it. And we can read our own text messages now, which is pretty useful. Oops. I thought it would, like, get rid of the actual floor we're on. Dude, what are those injuries? What are those injuries, man? Mishima.
I can't do it.
All right, dude, don't worry about it. It's not a big deal. Guess we can get to go home early today. That's pretty nice. Take a wild guess, man. Alright, I guess we're meeting Takamoto in the courtyard.
Can I talk to you for a sec?
What is it? You can never say no to
It'll
a lady.
Quick. Anyway, what's with you? Like how you were late the other day was a lie and all? There's that weird rumor about you, too.
What do you want with him?
Right back at you. You're not even in our class.
We just happened to get to know each other.
Yeah, Ryuji's pretty cool. I like him.
What are you planning on doing to Mr. Kamoshida?
Hopefully beating his face in, but I think he's a little bit too tall for that. So I'm probably just gonna go for the nuts.
Huh?
Hit him right in the volleyballs.
I see. I get ya. You're all buddy-buddy with Kamoshida after all.
This has nothing to do with you, Sakamoto.
If you found out what he's been doing behind your back, you'd dump him right away.
Ryuji, I don't think a lady like this would associate with a man like that.
Behind my back? What's that supposed to mean?
You wouldn't get it.
Anyway, people are already talking about you two. I don't know what you're trying to pull, but no one's gonna help you. I'm warning you, just in case. That's all.
You're concerned for us. I gotta admit, the gym outfit looks good on her.
Why should she be so aggressive all the time?
She seemed pretty annoyed.
She's been like that since middle school. Anyways, that's not what we're here to talk about. I had no luck on my end. What about you? Did anything like someone's name turn up?
Let's see. Emphysema... Kitajima... I think it was Mishima? I don't know the name, but...
Huh? Special coaching, huh?
Was that the guy who got hit in the face?
True. I always see the guy covered in bruises.
I guess it was.
Let's go talk to him before he leaves then. Hey, got a second?
Sakamoto?
And you too. Come on, we just want to chat.
Yeah, man, what's going on with you? Why are you always so beat up?
She's been coaching you, huh? You sure it's not just physical abuse?
So it sure sounds like it at this point.
Certainly not. What are you talking all polite for? Anyways, we saw him spike you today, right in the face. That was just because I'm not good at the sport.
Dude, seriously, like, real question though, are you okay? A spike like that looks like it would have given you a concussion. I'm amazed you're still here.
Still, that doesn't explain all the other bruises you've got.
Yeah, like, a lot of them seem almost, they seem inflicted from a secondary source, not necessarily from a ball or from accidents.
They're from practice.
Look, bruises from underneath the arms and maybe in the knees would make sense. That's like a diving position for saving the ball. But bruises like this? No way.
Is he forcing you to keep quiet? That's...
What's going on here? Mishima, isn't it time for practice?
I'm not feeling well today.
Dude, you spiked him in the face. Let him go home.
What? Maybe you're better off quitting then. You're never going to improve that crappy form unless you show up to practice.
Didn't you hear? He ain't feeling well.
Well, Mishima, are you coming to practice or not?
I'll go.
As for you...
Oh, jeez, he's so tall.
You'll be gone from this school for sure.
Bastard.
Same goes for you. Didn't the principal tell you to keep in line?
Dude, I haven't done anything. Oh, by the way, you have an amazing spike.
Just don't get in the way of my practice. All these unsettling rumors are making the students anxious, after all.
Why wouldn't it? Somebody's been spreading them around. Wonder who that could have been.
That's your own goddamn fault.
This won't get us anywhere. Let's go, Mishima. Shujin Academy is a place where those with aspirations come to learn. Unworthy students like yourselves don't have any right to be here. Get with the program.
Yes, sir. That asshole.
We'll get him.
He's gonna pay for this.
Somehow.
There's no point. Huh? Proving that he's physically abusing us is meaningless. Everybody knows. Principal, our parents, they all know. And they all keep quiet about it.
Dude, this is literally illegal.
This has gotta be a joke! Don't be a pain. You don't understand what I'm going through. Shouldn't you, of all people, know that nothing's going to help?
I think Ryuji, out of everybody, should understand exactly how that feels. Well... what now?
I'll try one more time to persuade the other guys. That's all I can do.
There's gotta be something else we can do. You know what? That other world's a good idea. There's gotta be something about it. Something more we can do there. Yeah, let's head to sleep. Whoa! Hey, this don't make any damn sense. This is a good question. Why in the world would they not be speaking up? I'm pretty sure it's probably because of the volleyball team. It's the only ticket they've got, right? I mean, considering the fact that the track team is gone, the volleyball team is the only thing outstanding about their sports division. So it's very likely that he just doesn't want, the principal specifically, probably doesn't want to lose another team. Yeah. Who in the world are you talking about? Wait. Ann Takamaki? Or Takamaki? I don't even know anymore. Oh, you mean that girl that's in front of me? Alright, that makes sense. Knowing, to be perfectly honest, knowing him, he's probably gonna cause a lot more trouble. I mean, I will admit, he's a damn good volleyball player, but that's pretty much all he is. That's entirely creepy. The faculty office, huh? Takamaki might be worth it, even if she's not on the team. Alright. Actually, that makes sense. If one of the starters is there, maybe she does know something. The teams are really reluctant to talk, and maybe the people around the teams might be more willing to talk. Though I don't think they'll be willing to talk to us. Yeah. Well, we'll see, I guess.
Shouldn't you be heading to volleyball?
Uh-huh.
Oh god, that bruise!
It's above your eye. Is that from practice, too?
I don't think so at all.
Yeah.
Are you sure you're not pushing yourself too hard?
I'm okay. Volleyball's the only thing I can do right.
I hate when people think like that.
Shouldn't you take that?
It's probably just my part-time job, I think.
I should get going.
Shiho.
Her eyes look so dead.
Are you sure you're okay?
Uh-huh.
Yes. Today won't work. I'm not feeling so good. Sorry. Bye.
Hey, wasn't that Takamaki?
Oh my god, I know, one of these lines is one of my freaking favorite lines in the game. Not because they're a good line, not because they're, like, well-written in any way, shape, or form. It's just the voice acting in this one line is goddamn hilarious. I will try not to laugh.
Rumor has it she's dating Kamoshida.
This student right here, his voice, I don't know who the hell voiced him, but he is so bad.
Seriously?
I heard people saw them in his car together.
You know, she seems pretty easy, huh? You think I'd have a chance too?
Come on, dude. You can't go after Kamoshida's bitch.
Sorry. The way he says the word bitch is just the best. It's just, hey man, you can't mess with Kamoshida's bitch. It's fucking, goddamn. Like, it's such a sad scene, and every time it just ruins the mood. I love it.
What is it?
Where did the voice line go? You know what? Don't even worry about it. Are you hurt?
Huh?
Oh, no more voice acting. Yeah, I'm apparently that infamous transfer student. Yeah, apparently, according to rumors, I drink a lot, I smoke a ton, and people seem to think I beat the hell out of people all the time. They don't really bother me.
Okay.
Wait, that blonde one? What was her name? An? She is pretty cute.
Then I'll...
Shiho, huh? Did you find someone?
Is that what it looks like?
No, but it was, you know, it was worth asking.
All of them kept saying the same shit Mishima was talking about. Kamoshida had to have told him something. At this rate, looks like we'll have to go to him directly.
Honestly, we should have started with that.
I know. But seriously, isn't there something we can do? No way I'm gonna give in like this. Can you think of anything?
The other world's the only thing I could think of.
Oh, that'd be fine if we could do it without getting caught, but if we did, we'd be seriously done for. You got any other ideas?
Well, we could call the cops.
So you want to tell them about the castle? They'd never believe us.
I mean, all we have to do is activate the app near them, right?
Have any other ideas? What do we do?
Why don't we punish the king?
The king? You mean that other world's Kamoshida? I didn't think of that, but is there any meaning to...
I finally found you!
Oh, that's a familiar voice. Never mind, that is not a familiar body.
Did you say something?
No, I didn't say nothing.
Don't think you can get away with not paying me back for helping you.
Oh my god, you are so cute!
That voice... Is that you, Morgana?
How dare you up and leaving me the other day!
Yeah, that was a bit rude,
the
I must admit.
Cat's talking?
I am not a cat! This is just what happened when I came to this world. It was a lot of trouble finding you two.
Wait, you came to our world? Does that mean you've got a phone?
You don't need one when you're at my level. I did get pretty lost making my escape, though.
Yeah, I figured as much.
That aside, why can you talk? You're a cat!
How should I know?
You hearing this too?
Yeah. Meow?
This is no time to be joking around!
You guys are having a rough time of this, hmm? I heard you mention something about witnesses.
Oh, shut up!
You know, I could tell you a thing or two about what to do about Kamoshida. You were pretty close just a moment ago.
God, that condescending attitude. This thing's gotta be Morgana.
Yeah, sounds like it.
You were still doubting me?
I mean, to be fair, it's hard to doubt a talking cat.
God, quiet down!
We really have to be looking for a cat in a busy time like this?
I just heard a meow somewhere near here. Didn't you hear it?
Make sure you check every nook and cranny around.
Meow? Does that mean only us two can understand what you're saying?
Looks like it.
What the hell's going on? Anyways, what you were talking about earlier, is it for real?
Yeah, is there anything we can actually do in that other world? I was thinking about it earlier.
You're quite the skeptic for being an idiot.
Hey, tell us more. Then again, this probably ain't the best place. Here, stick it in your bag for now. It should be just small enough to fit.
That's a cute meow it had for a second there.
Hey, how dare you treat me like... Don't be so rough with me.
Enough of that. You said you know how we can do something about Kamoshida, right?
It has to do with what this guy was talking about earlier. You'll need to attack his castle.
Sounds pretty reasonable.
That castle is how Kamoshida views this school. He doesn't realize what happens in there, but it's deeply connected to the depths of his heart. Thus, if the castle disappears, it would naturally impact the real Kamoshida.
Interesting.
What'd happen?
A palace is a manifestation of a person's distorted desires. So, if that castle were no more...
His desires would go too.
Precisely. You sure pick up things fast.
It comes with the territory.
For real? He's gonna turn good? But is that really getting back at him?
Erasing a palace essentially means forcing the owner to have a change of heart. However, even though their warped wants disappear, the crimes they committed remain.
Interesting.
Kamoshida will become unable to bear the weight of those crimes, and he'll confess them himself.
So without his heart's emotional resistance, he just has nothing left.
You for real? That's possible?
And since the palace will no longer exist, he'll forget what we did there as well. Not only will we be able to bring Kamoshida down, but there won't even be a trace of our involvement.
That's amazing! You are one incredible cat!
Literally the most incredible cat.
True. Except for the cat part.
So, how do we get rid of the palace?
By stealing the treasure held within.
Stealing?
I'll tell you more once you agree to go ahead with this. It's my most valuable secret plan, after all.
I mean, your plan doesn't seem very secret, considering we're the only ones you're talking to about it.
If you want to help me out, I'll gladly teach you. What's your call?
Our luck's running dry looking for witnesses. Guess we have no choice but to go along.
Yep, sounds good to me. There doesn't seem to be any other way.
Good. Oh, right. There's one more thing I should tell you. If we erase a palace, there is no doubt that the person's distorted desires will be erased as well. But desires are what we all need in order to survive. The will to sleep, eat, fall in love. Those sorts of things.
What are you getting at?
If all of those yearnings were to vanish, they'd be no different than someone who is shut down entirely.
Okay.
They may even die if they're not given proper care. So...
are you telling me he's gonna go catatonic if we fuck up?
They might die!
Will you listen to everything I have to say first?
Would their death be our fault?
This is a good question.
Aren't you determined enough to face those kinds of risks?
I mean, I feel like I am, but I don't want to be responsible for anybody else's life. Well, do we really have any choice but to risk it?
For real?
Sheesh. I come all this way and this is what I get. It's not like anyone will ever find out.
That's not the point. Oh, I forgot Ryuji said that.
If we just go around secretly doing whatever we want, we'd be no better than that effing Kamoshida.
Yeah, I wouldn't feel comfortable if I actually put him into a literal brain-dead state.
Isn't this your only option?
I mean, you're giving me the... making me feel like it is.
I'll come back later. Make sure you've made your decision by then.
Alright.
Man, we're getting all worked up for nothing. Damn it! I'll try and see if I can figure out another way. Come on, let's get out of here.
Alright, Ryuji, let's get out of here. Yeah, let's head home. Wait a minute, what do you mean? Yeah. Both don't really seem interested in him at all. Like, a lot of the girls in the school do, but they don't. They don't seem to be into muscle heads. Alright. Let's go home. Oh wait, couldn't I just fast travel? Well, I guess I don't really have much of a choice. Let's go to Café LeBlanc.
Will you please give it a rest? I told you, I'm not feeling up to it. Wait, what? That's not what you promised. And you call yourself a teacher? This has nothing to do with Shiho.
She seems...
Shiho's starting position.
Oh god, she's so down. Excuse me.
Wait, were you listening?
Not on purpose. I was just passing by.
Haven't you heard of privacy? No, I was out of line. Sorry.
Don't worry about it. You seem to be having a tough time.
So... how much did you hear?
Something about a friend.
Shiho. It's nothing at all. Nothing.
Hey, wait up. We actually needed to talk to her anyway, right? We might as well help her out. I can't leave her be. Alright, let's go. Why is she just staring at the pillar? To be perfectly honest, I can't.
No.
Let's go somewhere safe, alright?
I don't have anything to talk about with you. It was just an argument.
With a teacher.
You heard every last word then.
Yeah.
Thank you very much!
You've heard the rumors, haven't you? About Mr. Kamoshida. Everyone says we're getting it on. But that's so not true. That was him on the other line. I avoided giving him my number for the longest time. He told me to go to his place after this. You know what it means. If I turn him down, he said he'd take my friend off as a regular on the team. I've been telling myself this is all for Shio's sake. I can't take it anymore. I've had enough of this. I hate him. But still, Shio's my best friend. She's all I have left in that sorry excuse of a school. Tell me, what should I do? Sorry, I shouldn't have asked. It's not your problem.
Well, it may not have been my problem before, but it is my problem now.
What am I saying? I barely even talked to you before.
Maybe that's why. Sometimes it's easier to talk to people you don't know.
You might be right. You're so weird. Usually everyone just ignores me.
That's a little odd. I feel like you'd be really hard to ignore.
Are you really a bad person, as the rumor says? You just don't seem like it.
Baby, I'm bad to the bone.
Is that supposed to be a joke?
Maybe.
I kinda had a feeling they were all just exaggerations. You seemed lonely. Almost like you didn't belong anywhere.
You might be right on that one.
You're the same in that regard. Maybe that's why it was so easy for me to talk to you.
Maybe.
Is there really no way for me to help Shio? I wish he'd just change his mind. Like, forget about me and everything. As if something like that would ever happen.
Well, you never know. It could happen.
I wasn't asking for a serious response. But I do feel a bit better now. I'm gonna head home.
Alright, have a safe trip.
Don't tell anyone what I told you, okay? I'll try and think of a way to persuade Kamoshida. Well, thanks.
Do what you can, alright? But stay safe. Don't push yourself.
Are you leaving?
What is it?
Mr. Kamoshida's asking for you. He's in the PE faculty office.
What did he say?
I don't know. Well, I have to go.
I have a really, really bad feeling about this. Well, you know, some thug was bothering me. Yeah, I know, I'm in deep shit. Calm down, old man. No, actually. I made a friend.
Oh.
Yeah, you know what? I thought the same thing. Good point. Well then, why don't you just give me a key so you don't have to stay up late?
Hey.
Yeah, I'm not sure if he's a guy who would be worth killing. I'm not sure what to say, man. Well, we'll see, I guess. But for now, I think I'm gonna end off here. It seems like my dogs are barking a lot, which means they probably want to go outside, so I will save here for now.
I'll just add this.
And I will see you guys in the next episode. I'm just gonna have to take a little bit of a break so I can actually take those dogs out. So, see you guys in the next one. Later, everybody.